All right, I have an update from the painting. I have another brush. I know I've been doing this with the duck feather brushes, but this one is much tinier and it's much more refined. So, yeah, if you do have the stinging nettle versions, they do snap. So keep, bear that in mind. You may lose your favorite brush that way. Be gentle. I actually want to talk about. Yeah, I don't want to be a tutorial on how to paint, that's for sure. I don't want to be my follower on this direction. I want to talk about gods, actually. I did get a head jump thought. I've already been thinking it many, many days. But it's been a reminder, so I got reminded by video man there, I'll call him. and so we're talking gods here. We're talking gods. And it's everybody's out, oh, there's this god over here, there's this version of this god, and there's the ones of my thoughts, and this is the way it goes. And so I'll tell you this relationship with this version of gods, which is much kind of more interesting, because I know I've been dealing so much with all of this, like the foods, the this is affecting me, that is affecting me, and this other thing is affecting me. And so now I just kind of want to take it back to spiritual realm for a moment. And then when I take it back to spiritual realm for a moment, it's like, oh my goodness. Today is one day, and so you have the God day. Each day you wake, another day of a God is, and you can take that as a child has been born into the world, a special child. Each day, one a day, only you get one. That sounds like a commercial, doesn't it? Yeah, a fresh God each day. However. The relationship of this new persona, this new energy force would be exactly that. What is going on in this day? Is it a furious day for you? Is it a ferocious day in your energy? You know, and so perhaps that is a furious type of God release. That's it. We have to deal with that particular element of that's the future. There's the future is this particular God. So each day that wakes is another morning. It is another expression of what is it about here? What is it all about? You know. And it's a good way to go through and go, well, today is, oh my gosh, we have a complete rambunctious God, or we have a God that is completely calm. And when we get the calm God, you know, the quiet God, the tranquil God, or even a God that is so strong that it's lasted many days now here, that is forcing me to be even ridiculous in the paint on this canvas here in front of a camera and upload it to the internet, you know. So in the lifetime we are an accumulation of gods that have been born, if this makes sense. So wherever your birth date was, you can look at all of them as grown. So we are essentially walking amongst these grown gods. And yes, some of them are the children now, but some of them are the older also. So there are special people that are just born, and I'm not sure why. They just are. So I guess that's just the way of looking at it. It's what is this offering? What is this offering of each new day is a new it could be a funny chance for sure, it can be a funny God day, it can be an absolutely anxietal God, it can be what are we gonna do, yeah, we can't have too many of those. And it's not a choice, it's not even a choice we can make. It's not a choice, it is the flow of the day, it is the expression of the nature. It is how the clouds are going by. Are they speedy? Are they fast? Are they overwhelmed with the tortures and torments of electric rapidity, and they want a lightning bolt? You know, is this happening? Is it this type of God? Is it an over dramatic? You can say, well, he's an over dramatic God. Then we have over dramatic gods that are waking, but this is not a God. I'm saying there's only one per day. So that would be on the calendar. You get the 365. So you go with this version. It's kind of a funny way to make it through the day. It's like which God has been released, and then I'm thinking also it is a release, oddly the prison womb, but so there, what God, and how many there, and as life is going on further and further, I'm like, how many am I living around and are in this consumption experience, you know? It's like a shaman. Some shamans everywhere, and so if I have the 365, if I run that calendar, I have the 365 times what? How many years I'm into here? I'm not even sure. But you can go with the go try to get your savant head out there and get up the number in a hurry, because it's a speed out, huh? I gotta speed out and get that number in a hurry. Oh my gosh, apparently that one has tapped into me, and I don't know why I have to condone it. I keep pushing that one out, that particular, hurry up with the number, you know. You have to know exactly the 365 times your date of age in your birth year. And as soon as you get that, then you are a success. You are a success, and there is a moment of relief? Relief once you enter that calculation and that answer. There is a mild happiness, yeah, I guess there is happiness in mathematics. There is also, what do you call it? A tranquility, a quieting. I know I just can't do it right now. I can't be looking at all of these numbers on the. I can't do that right now. Isn't that bizarre? Isn't that bizarre? It's almost as if I am blocked by it. But I like to think of it. I like to think of it directly as these gods of these powers. Let's think of these gods of these powers that are fighting over the accumulation of how our thoughts are even gathered, and that is the day. That is the day. And when they say the day, it even makes it funnier, because you can look at it as DEI. DEI, yeah. Let's look at it as DEI. Another day.